to take out the dash of a 2008 Jeep Liberty.
Good luck!
To start this project, let's make some room. Unbolt the front two seats, and in this case, I push them to the back of the Jeep. It makes plenty of room, and we'll definitely need it.
Let's start at the bottom of the dash here. There's these screws. So you pull this down, right? And down here is also the blower engine. This piece right here. If that ever goes bad, just switch it out with a couple screws. Really easy. Onto this radio cover, you're gonna like push down and pull this up, and it's just these clips that come off. It is really tight in here to take this out, so I would recommend to put this in neutral before you take the battery off and just pull the e-brake up. But I'm gonna unclip it and then pull it out. Alright, take out the radio, four screws. Okay, so you're gonna lift it from the corners there up, and it just clips. It just comes up. You gotta remove the 4x4. Alright, there's two screws in the box, and then screws on the corners. The e-brake has a zipper. You gotta pull down. I'm just gonna lift it up. We're gonna take this part out and then unscrew this here. That's already unscrewed. Unscrew there. Underneath the steering wheel, just pull this down. This front part, you lift it from the bottom. This clips, also the other side, and on top, just slowly lift it up around. This top part, it's one piece. Just goes through that. Don't start with this one yet. Start with the next one. And this one starts in this corner, and it just pops out. And then unbolt this metal piece. Next, we're taking off this handle. There's two screws at the bottom. All right, the glove box. Squeeze the two ends. It comes down. These drawers, you slide it over, and it comes out. First, you have to take this panel off. You can take it off by turning this little thing. And then after that, that's when this side vent will come out. You have to start it from the bottom. Take it out, and then the top will come out. Side panel, pull it out from the top. And that little slot comes out. And again, that twisty thing. After that, the dash piece will come out. There's three bolts, two there, one there. Both side panels are going to come out. Pull it from the side and out. Underneath the driver's side and passenger side, there's this bolt. I'm gonna take that out and these cords. Remove that center piece in this vent. Right underneath the passenger side, there's a bolt.
The first step to removing the steering wheel is removing the airbag. In the back of the steering wheel, there's these three slots. They have this hook clip. And the way I remove the airbag is by pushing it forward to give it wiggle room. And then I took a flat screwdriver and popped those clips outward and up. And then unclipped the wires.
Before taking this airbag off, make sure you ground yourself for safety. You don't want it blowing up in your face. Cover for the steering wheel. There's three screws, one right there and on the corners. To remove the steering wheel, it says bolt. And just remember how it goes back with this clip on the top, that little hook at the bottom. If you're having a hard time taking that screw out, turn the steering wheel all the way till it gets stuck. Then you can twist it off. The center of the steering wheel has that dot at the top. Make sure you line it up as you put it back in. This steering wheel was really hard to take off, so you might need two or three jaw. I just rented this kit from Advance Auto. For the clock spring, there's three bolts. One right there, one on that corner, and one right there. And it just pops out. Just unhook the cords. Take this plate from under there. There's two bolts right underneath the steering wheel. One right there. One right there. Before you pull out the dash, make sure you unplug some of these tight cords. That one, that's the gas pedal. To remove the dash, you're gonna do like a twist up and out motion. And so you might not have to remove that. And make sure you, well, I labeled some of the cables just to remember where they go. Okay, to remove the dash, you wanna do like a twist motion like that. It won't come out straight. If you're pulling straight, it won't come out. You have to twist it up and down. So you might not have to remove the steering wheel part out. All right, to take out the dash, you have to remove this cord from underneath, and it goes through that hole all the way to the front. It goes out the front, and it's gonna connect to that, and underneath the tire. You're going to unclip it right there. You got it? We're going to remove the AC unit and that bolt down there. Alright, the unit is going to pop out of those two holes. This is what the new part looks like. Comes with the kit. You can get this. You might need it. You might not. Alright, we got the whole unit out. Right, the heater core unit has these two clamps at the bottom, and then that one. I'll just unhook it.
There it is.
And that screw there, and this clamp.
Take off those rings, and then we will put it back on, make sure the teeth are forward. You do not need to open this box to get to the heater core. The heater core just pops out. There's clips on the sides. Just lift those up. Right, the heater core has four clips. There, 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 and there. And as you can see, this is why it's bad. It was leaking. Dale. And this is how you put it back. That screw, that clamp. Make sure it goes back together how it was. And this is probably a good time to check your AC evaporator in here to get a part. Now we gotta put everything back together. This is how I put all my parts. From the middle of the dash, driver side, and passenger side. It's really helpful to label your nuts and bolts too.